Don't bother me, I'm working. Don't bother me, I'm working.
So good morning, good morning, good morning. Been out on the road, y'all. Been away, trying to find a place to stay outside of VA. And so I'm back now, trying to get back on track with these videos. And I just want to tell y'all this, because I hear people asking me, how did I get the way that I am? Like, I had an older guy pull me to the side one time when I was at an event, and he said, "Who pulled you to the? Who talked to you? Who pulled you to the side and spoke to you?" Is what he asked me, and I was like, "Nobody." You know what I mean? Because at the time, I couldn't remember anybody really talking to me. But now that I think back to the question, I do remember one time I was getting in a lot of trouble. I was in the middle of fighting some charges. Luckily for me, I was a minor at the time, but I was fighting some charges, and my mom, she pretty much washed her hands with me. So she had my dad, who wasn't he wasn't living with us, and he was barely in my life at the time, but she had him set up like a little meeting, I guess, between me and all my dad's brothers and his cousins. And they just basically centered around me and just tried to talk some sense into me. But during that talk, one of my uncles pretty much really got to me. I ain't gonna lie, I didn't realize how much he was getting to me at the time. But when I think back to it in hindsight, he was actually getting to me and helping me believe in myself, simply because he was telling me that he believed in me. You know what I mean? There's something about when a person looks you in your eye and tells you with the most sincere conviction that they really do believe in you. Because sometimes it takes for somebody else to believe in you for you to believe in yourself. But anyway, back to my original point. So people ask me, how did I get the way that I am? And I'll tell you a couple of key things, and which is, number one, I remember when I first used to look up on YouTube, because when I started, I had first figured out that you can actually look on YouTube and find these motivational videos and talks and stuff. I started off typing in business seminars, and then I started finding out stuff from there. That's what I used to always type. And in one of those early videos, I heard a man say in one of his talks that the three words that kill people or hold people back is, "I know that." And I've mastered the art of not saying "I know that." And it's taken me a long way, because say, for example, if I'm talking to you right now, you're a franchise owner with a cleaning company, and I'm a franchise owner with a cleaning company. You're telling me about, you want to tell me about the fees and how they work. I will sit back and listen to everything that you got to say before I chime in. Versus most people would cut you off and automatically say, "Oh no, I know that already. I already know about that." Oh, you know what I mean? It could be easy for me to simply say, "Oh no, 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 you got to tell me. Go look at my YouTube. I can tell you all about that." But the way I am, I'll be quiet in the entire time and let you talk. Simply because I just know that you just might, throughout all the talking that you're doing, say something that I don't know. And then even if you don't, then you know what? What do I gain by cutting you off and boasting that I know something anyway, other than, I guess, my time? You know what I mean? But other than that, like, it's better that 9 times out of 10, if you just let people talk, you probably will something when they're talking, because they might just say, even if it's only one small thing out of like 1,000 things that they said, it's one more thing that you can know. So I always try to listen more than I talk. You know, they say that you got 2 ears and 1 mouth for a reason, and I just pretty much, I almost never say "I know that," and that's one of the things that takes me a long ways. I get people who call me all the time or talk to me in person, ask me a question about something, and as soon as I get ready to explain it to them and get to talking to them, next thing you know, they're cutting me off and telling me stuff as if they're the ones trying to teach me. And then next thing you know, they're doing more talking than I do talking, and they end up walking away with basically what they came with, because they did all the talking. And I just think that's ironic how people will talk to the person that they might want to be considered their mentor, or talk to a person that they feel like has more knowledge than them, or might be in a position where they feel like they want to be in. But when you talk to them, you do all the talking. You got to learn how to just shut up and listen. really got to learn that, and that's what something that I do. That's why it surprises me that I'm able to even do these YouTube videos, because I'm not very talkative at all. And if you meet me in person, I'll be probably pretty laid back, and I'm going to let you do the talking. The only way that I'll do the talking is if you let me, or if you make me, you force me, pretty much, because that's the way I am. I have a reactive personality. Like, if I see that you're not going to be an open person, I'll be the open person. You know what I mean? But if you're going to do all the talking, I'll let you do all the talking. You know, it all depends on the situation and what I deem necessary at the moment. But I just want to put that out there. That really took me a long way, understanding simply to just shut up and listen and not say, I know that. I know that will kill you sometimes. All right? So that's one of the things I want to get off my chest. Another thing that's taken me a long way throughout my journey is the fact that I don't do anything that doesn't make sense to me. And what I mean is, if whether good or bad or whatever the case may be, if it doesn't make sense to me, I won't do it. So just like in the military, for example, and I'm sorry to any military vets who listen to me, I appreciate your service because you guys do keep us safe. However, in my particular personal situation, I'm not capable of just doing something simply because somebody told me to. I need to know why. I'm not afraid to ask why. And that's the way I've always been. I'm just wired to be that way. Because if you tell me to go over to some other country and bomb this particular area just because you told me to, I can't go for that. And then if you tell me the reason is because, well, they were plotting on getting us, I still probably can't go for that, because I'm like, well, who told you that? Well, how you know? You know what I mean? Do you speak the language of it? You know what I mean? It's like so many things that go into it. You know what I mean? So I can't do things that don't make sense to me. Like if the manual to some company or something says, well, we have to make something a certain way just because they said so, I can't go off of just because they said so. I need to know why. Is it because if I don't do it that way that I might get hurt? You know what I mean? Or is it because I might not make the product correctly? Like, what is the reason? I need to know the why in order to do that. You know what I mean? Like, that's the way that I am. And I feel like it almost makes me seem like a rebel. Almost. And in some instances, I probably am. But it makes you that much more... makes you learn that much more out of a situation, because you need to know the why. Once you know the why, then you actually have reasoning behind the action that you're taking, which makes you that much more intelligent about the situation. You know what I mean? So I just want to encourage you to ask why. You know what I mean? Don't just do things because somebody said don't do it. Just like I get people to ask me about a cleaning franchise, and they say, oh, what company are you with? Even if I tell you the name of the company that I'm with, that shouldn't have anything to do with, like, what company I'm with it shouldn't matter to you, because I'm giving you all the tools to choose the right company for you anyway. You know what I mean? So don't go off of what other people are doing or what other people say. Go off of your best, the knowledge that you have, and making the best decision for you. You know what I mean? Now, if you're asking me what company I'm with, and then you, because you want to know why, I understand that, because I would want to know why too. But don't just say, oh, what company you with? Well, I'm going to go with them because you with them. That's not very smart. All right? So we just got to do smart things. You know what I mean? To stop. Don't say, I don't know. Oh, no, excuse me. Don't say, I know that. But don't say, I don't know either, because it's not such thing as I don't know. But don't say, I know that, because you could limit yourself from learning new information from an unsuspected source. Or unexpected source, rather. And then the next thing is, just simply ask why. Have a questioning mentality and make sure that you don't do things just because the masses are doing it, because everybody else does it, or because that's the way it's always been done. You know what I mean? No, actually understand why you're doing something, and make sure it's in alignment with what your personal goals are. If it doesn't align with what you're trying to do, stop. Do something else. You know what I mean? Or see if you can change what you're doing to make it fit what you agree with. Alright, so, but that's just some words for you this morning. I'm tired, I can't lie, I've been on the road, I'm trying to get out of the state, And me and my fiance, we just got back in town not too long ago, so I want to rest up. But I thank you guys for watching, subscribing, liking, sharing, and commenting. This is AJ Simmons, and I need you guys to do this. Check out my website, ajsimmonsonline.com. And if you go to, if you look at it, very soon as you go to the website, at the top of the page, you'll see that I have my Etsy shop that I'm setting up. And you'll see the little display at the top of the page. So I have my ebook on there now, so you don't have to go through Amazon anymore. I also have one form uploaded up there for sale, which is the account information form. I'm going to put all forms from now on. I have those up there available for you in my online store. And then I'm also going to put together, I'm about to have a lot of tools for you guys, especially for those who start the cleaning companies. And then I'm also have other products as well that I'm going to put on there. So just keep, stay posted and make sure you check in the site from time to time just to see my updates. All right, that's ajsimmonsonline.com. Also, make sure you like the Facebook page. It's facebook.com/ajsimmonsonline. And follow me at ajsimmonsonline. So I appreciate you guys for watching again. And thank you. Share this information if you find it helpful. And I'll talk to y'all next week.